This is your passenger brief, just to make sure everything is okay, comfortable, and then just to let them know that even though they're out of control, they should try and avoid
things. Okay, okay, all right.
In this video, we talk about pre-flight briefings, tips, and what to include in the briefings, as well as what you have to do after an emergency has occurred.
We are about to stall,
and this is our adventures in and around South Africa. As part of your flight training, you learn about pre-flight briefings that are vital to safety and flight operations, for not only your training, but into the future flying adventures as well. In this dedicated video, part 8 in the flight training series, we learn all about the passenger, crew, and emergency briefings. After my instructor Shamir introduced me to the pre-flight briefings, I realized how important they are and pulled him aside to make a dedicated video about it. If you have some tips to share, or if we missed something, please share it in the comments below. Just a disclaimer, although this video is meant to be informative, it should not be used as instruction. Please consult your instructor.
So before you go on a flight, there is three briefings that you want to cover. The first one is not necessarily a briefing per se if you're doing instruction or flying with another pilot. It's more of a briefing for safety related, similar to what you get in the airline when they show you your exits and your seat belts and all those things, that upright position. So it's a similar thing. Obviously our seat is non-reclinable. So you're going to tell your passenger, just for the perspective of safety, so they know where everything is, you're going to give them a passenger brief. The passenger brief is very brief. You don't want to add too much. You don't want to get their stress levels up.
This is your passenger brief, just to make sure everything is okay, comfortable, and then just to let them know that even though they're out of control, they should try and avoid
All right.
So any way that you want to do it, there's four things that you must mention. Keep your seatbelts fastened, keep your hands and feet clear of the controls, this is an exit and emergency exit, and then keep a lookout with me. If you see something, say something.
Okay, all right, cool.
So that one we call the passenger briefing. Again, it's only done if you're flying with passengers. You can, for the duration of the training, you will always give me the passenger briefing, and then you're going to give me what we call the crew briefing. The point of training we're getting to now is where you're more hands-on in the flight. So you'll see I'm probably sitting there with my hands on my knees or holding something or whatever else. You're basically flying at this point. So just to clarify between us, you're going to do what we call a crew briefing. You're going to tell us what our intention of flight is. So because we're at an uncontrolled airfield, we will typically look at the windsock and determine which runway we're going to use. Just so when we enter the runway and you decided to backtrack and I thought we're going to line up on the one way, there's no confusion between the two of us. Then you're going to say what our intention of that flight is. So a good example is we're going to take off, maybe we climb straight out, or we're going to do a left hand out or a right hand out and we're going to climb to X altitude, and then say what we're going to do in the general flying area. The last thing you want is for your crew or other pilot, be it an instructor or just a normal pilot friend, you don't want them to sit next to you and you're busy taking off and you decide to do a low out or early right or something and they don't really realize that you're doing this and they get a little bit of a fright thinking, oh, what happened to Carl, what happened there, you know. So just give your crew a little bit of information on what your intention of the flight is, what runway you're going to use and what your general intentions for that flight will be.
Awesome. Okay, then I'm going to introduce you to the runway emergencies, which is now a crew briefing.
Okay.
The crew briefing has the emergency section, which must be mentioned, and then we do just a general discussion between two crew. Specifically now, if you're flying with another guy that is a pilot, you don't want to have an emergency situation and the guy thinks, oh, I have more power, so I'm going to take control.
Yeah.
So you just roughly run through it. So in the situation that we're currently in, as the instructor and you're not yet solo, should we have any emergency, I will take full control.
Yeah.
I may not necessarily
say
I have control, but should we have an emergency, assume me to have full control.
Okay, yeah. Okay, now I will try and say you have control.
Yeah, if that's obviously now if time permits. Okay.
Yeah.
Then the emergency section will be, if we're on the runway, these are all based on takeoffs, right? So in the event of an emergency, before rotation, we will close the power, apply the brakes, shut down the aircraft. Should we need to, we'll evacuate away from the engine. In the event of an emergency, after rotation, with sufficient runway, we will select flaps as required, land back on the runway, close the power, shut down the aircraft, and then again, if need be, evacuate away from the engine. In the event of an emergency after rotation with insufficient runway, we will select a field 30 degrees off our nose, so 15-15, and then we're going to select flaps as required, do a radio call, land the aircraft as safely as possible. If time permits or necessitates, we will close the power shutdown and then evacuate away from the engine. The evacuating bits that we add in there is obviously based on an assessment. We're not going to just jump out and let the thing run.
Yeah.
So we will assess it. There's not necessarily a reason for us to evacuate or get out of the machine.
After a few more lessons, we recap the briefings that I now give to Shamir each time, and he shared some tips for me to improve on. You're welcome to share your tips in the comments below, and if you are enjoying these videos so far, please consider subscribing to help this channel grow, and hit the notification bell so you'll be the first to know when the next video is released.
Okay, then while we're waiting, let me just highlight that. So the emergencies, you're mentioning what you should, but you want to sweeten it also a little bit.
Okay.
Not necessarily to make it sound more at ease.
Yeah.
But you want to get it a little bit more fluent. So initially when you started, you said in the event of anything on the runway, don't be too specific.
Yeah.
So like a lot of people will go, in the event of engine failure, I will close the power, land back on the runway, whatever.
Yeah.
And what happens if a tower in front of you? You are at no risk of hitting him because he's way over there, but you are at risk of the takeoff. So now it becomes an aborted takeoff.
Yeah.
Or you're taxiing and your wheel goes flat. So there's a lot of different scenarios that can play out there. And any one of the scenarios means we must abort the takeoff. So that emergency that we have of close power apply brakes or land the plane close power apply brakes, all of those things doesn't necessarily mean a specific item that will happen. Most common one is where people go, in the event of an engine failure. It's not likely that you're going to get an engine failure in today's technology.
Yeah.
If you do have one in there, you either got a bad AP or you were tampering on your engine.
Yeah.
But realistically,
but in the event of something happening,
yeah, so
requiring us to abort the
takeoff. Exactly. So to make it sweeter and to make it easy on your tongue, just go, in the event of an emergency, and then by the word emergency, you've broadened the spectrum to anything from a idiot running across your runway, a mole jumping out, a bird flying past you, an engine failure or engine fire,
yeah,
or even forgetting your pitot tube, your pitot cover.
Yeah,
you know?
See that the HP is not coming up.
Exactly. Okay, then that brings us to another topic. So let's say you're flying, and this is probably something that you don't really get covered. You're busy doing your circuits, you're alone, you're solo, and you have this emergency with insufficient runway, and you put the aircraft down outside of the field. What do you do then? If you had time, you would have probably done a radio call. Typically, something like mayday, 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 engine failure, off 02, off 20. But you put the plane down, you land it safely, not a lot of damage to the plane, not hopefully nothing wrong with you either. Then the question comes, what do you do then? In a situation like that, you must remain with your aircraft. If you have your phone, call your instructor, call the school, call the owner of the aircraft, and then they will follow standard procedure whereby we will check on the CAA website for the investigator or accident and incidents department. We'll check who's online and we'll give them a call. You cannot move the aircraft until CAA gives you permission to move that plane. Safe flying. So hopefully it doesn't happen, eh?
That's it for the briefings episode, and I really hope that you learned as much as I did, especially about emergency briefings. Please consider subscribing if you want to see more content like this, and stay tuned because next time we really are about to stall as we do the stall exercises. Until then, dream big, fly high, and live the adventure.